Hello, everybody. This is The Fling Thing, and this will be my second commentary video here on my channel. As a result of my last commentary video doing surprisingly well, I decided to do another one about a topic I've seen in a lot of my favorite franchises, and that is the idea of characters having PTSD. I definitely understand the appeal of these kinds of story arcs. It's always interesting to see characters struggle with hatred, depression, and complex emotions, and sometimes it's even one of the main reasons I enjoy specific characters. Talking about you, Toga. Because it can be written in a way that can explain why the characters are the way that they are, such as Himiko Toga or Tomura Shigaraki from My Hero Academia, can also explain a character's motivations for things and why they strive after something, such as Michael Scott from the popular comedy TV show The Office. He wants everyone to like him and notice him because of his traumatic and lonely childhood. It can also show a character's progression through a show like MK from Monkey Kid. So let's take a deeper look at MK. The fact that he struggles with PTSD in the series, especially in the later seasons, is such a big part of his character development throughout the show, and a big part of the plot as well, as it strengthens the villains as well by showing how intimidating they can be. But one of the main things it shows is how it affects his relationship with the group, especially when the other members of the group, such as Mei, also have traumatic experiences. One of the main contrasts I'd like to point out is when Mei first gets the Samadhi firepower, how she flies off believing she is now a monster after seeing the damage she caused to her friends. MK, of course, takes this pretty hard because he doesn't want her to suffer alone after a traumatic event. And then the very next season, MK goes through a literal fight with a dark version of himself, and then he starts believing he's a monster, and the one who most tries to comfort him, of course, is Mei, because she went through something similar in the season before, and she knows exactly how MK is feeling in that particular moment, and it shows the very real bond that grows through trauma of characters, and how trust can be difficult, especially when multiple people in a group go through traumatic experiences. This is a well-written story about trauma, and it shows the bond between the characters and how they care for each other, as well as creates obstacles in their relationship with each other. This show has created some of the best platonic relationships I've seen, like it's up there with freaking Kingdom Hearts. Now, trauma doesn't always have to advance a character. Sometimes it can just be written in a way where it adds to the world building. And what better example to use than one of the best world-building stories, in my opinion, My Hero Academia. Now, this show is full of traumatized characters. We have Shoto, Hawks, Midoriya, Ochako, Lady Nagant, and all of the villains, including even Overhaul to some extent, and the list goes on. And each of these characters' backgrounds and motivations all add something to the story. Now, Shoto doesn't really have a clear motivation, or at least it's never blatantly stated, but his story adds so much to the world building because it shows that not all people labeled heroes in this society are good people, and some have very selfish motivations, and this is clearly a problem that won't be fixed anytime soon because Bakugo's a hero now. All right, relax, Bakugo fans, it's a joke. But anyways, each of these characters have something to add, and each one reveals a lot of the many, many problems with the world the characters live in. Like, maybe everyone should stop shaming people for being quirkless, or having a quirk that manifests itself differently, or acting like All Might's a literal god, when clearly there's people he can't save. This show's complex world building shows what happens when people put way too much faith in a system, and it's so interesting because the way it's presented, because it's presented entirely through the characters and their experience, which in my opinion is the best way to introduce your world building, and a writing technique that I have adopted myself. Now, because the idea of traumatized characters has been such a trend nowadays, I've seen it written very badly, and almost like this thing has come over writers where they now believe that a character can't be interesting if they don't have some kind of tragic backstory or something. And like, yes, your character needs some kind of conflict or something they're chasing after, But they don't have to be this, like, unstable, troubled character from the start to be interesting. Like, MK at the beginning of Monkey Kid was a fairly mentally stable person. He had a loving father, great friends, a decent place to live, and yet his inner struggles in the beginning were things that just everyone can relate to, like doubting yourself, being too hard on yourself, thinking you're not good enough. Characters can have interesting internal struggles without needing to have a deep, emotionally scarring backstory right from the start. And I could go on a long rant for hours here on the reasons why I hate that stupid Netflix movie, Nimona, but I'll talk about something you guys are more interested in, and that's Ninjago Dragons Rising. Now, I know you all think this next part of the video is just gonna be me hating on Ninjago Dragons Rising, but no, I'll start with the positives. Also, let me know if you want me to make a separate video about this spin-off show, because, oh boy, I have a lot of opinions about it. But anyway, let's start with the positives. So, how does this show use its traumatized characters to develop their world-building or characters? Now, from the beginning, this show suffered from being a reboot of an old show that was already failing after 7 bad and or mediocre seasons at best. Now, they had a rough start for sure, but they managed to do a few things well, and that kept me going through it. Like, one of the things I really liked was the new emphasis on backstory, especially since we don't get much of that in the original show. I think Sora's backstory did a great job introducing our new antagonists and the world building of her particular city. Now, Sora's backstory I have a few issues with, but I'll save that for another video if you guys are interested. I also think that Eren shows an interesting character perspective on what the merge did to people, because they've kind of added the fact that it's a reboot into the plot, and I think that's very creative. But yeah, it's just, I wish we could see more of his backstory with his parents and perhaps other characters that were affected negatively by the merge in similar ways that he was. Now, my main problem with this spin-off show is Lloyd. Now, it's no secret that the writers literally have no idea what to do with Lloyd, and haven't for some time. But now they've given him this new role as Sensei Wu's replacement. Now, this sounds great in theory, but so far in Season 2, they've been trying to develop this, like, PTSD arc with him, and in my mind, it's not working. Now, I know some people really like it, but in my mind, it's just kind of similar to what they did with him in Crystallize, where they just don't know what to do with him, so they try to make the audience empathize with him, and they never resolve any of his issues. And they haven't really resolved his issues since Season 8. But so far, this new trauma arc for Lloyd hasn't really built on the world's building or developed any new interesting areas to his character, so I just don't see the point of it. Maybe you all can explain it to me in the comments, because right now I just don't understand the appeal of it. I guess I just want writers to finally do something with Lloyd's character instead of putting him in infinite PTSD loops that never get resolved. So anyway, enough about that. In conclusion, giving trauma to characters can be a very interesting way to give them deep, meaningful relationships or build on the world. However, I believe there needs to be a purpose for writing trauma to your characters and not just attempting to make them feel more interesting. Because if there's a character who's just traumatized for the sake of it, it's not interesting. But anyways, that'll wrap it up for my thoughts here today. I hope you all enjoyed. Let me know if you liked this commentary and what I should do in the future for more commentary videos. Love you guys. Thanks again for watching. Peace out.